Hey guys, Matt Allen here. Welcome back to Tactical Bassin. Today we're headed back underwater. Springtime is prime time to throw the big swim bait. So we're taking eight of the most popular baits subsurface. We'll see the difference in how the tails kick, how the bodies move, so you can get a feel for which styles fit your fishing as we head into spring. We've got eight baits for you today. We're about to head underwater, but before we do, let me explain what we've got. For every bait, we're going to run four clips. Three of them real-time speed, and the fourth clip at half speed. So the first three clips will show you what the bait looks like underwater. The fourth clip will slow it down enough so you can see the subtle differences. Look at how the tail kicks. Look at whether or not the head hunts. Look at whether or not that bait is rocking and rolling and throwing a little bit of light. Each one will be different. So again, four clips per bait. Also, this was shot in very cold water. So this is the most subtle that any of these baits will be. In your water, as we go into spring and that water temperature comes up, all eight baits will get more aggressive and more reactive. All right, let's head underwater. Well, what did you think? Did you have some favorites? Could you see some differences? At the least, you could tell the difference between the wedge tail style baits and the boot tail styles. Those wedge tails are subtle. They're natural. That kick is slow moving. They really focus on realism, how these fish move in the water, and they shine in cold water. As we come out of winter into spring, those baits are going to shine for you. Did you have a favorite? We threw three of them. That first one, the Savage Gear, that one's newer to the market and they have done an amazing job. That is a line through bait. So I ran it with a belly treble. You can also take that treble, route it through, and run it on the back. Same bait can be rigged either way, depending on if you're going to fish up in the water column like we did in the video, or take it down to the bottom and just slow creep it and let it bottom bounce. It's great for both. The next one, the Matte Lure Shad, another amazing option. Did you see how good that bait looks? It's got a little more subtle tail kick, but it's a gizzard shad profile. It's a large shad. It swims incredibly well. It's got a great jig hook on it. That is a reliable swimming bait. What I love about that is it's got enough kick that when you're throwing it, you actually feel it on the end of the line, which is nice. Some wedge tails, you don't even feel them. You have to believe that they're working properly. That Matte Lures has a good kick, a little bit of vibration, and still has that natural look. And then last, the Huddleston. We had to include a Huddleston in this video. You can't talk wedge tail style baits without throwing one. It's tried and true. It's really what brought that entire genre to market. And it's great. It looks good, it's reliable, it's a good swimming bait, and it has caught a ton of giant fish. Now let's switch over. Let's talk boot tails. We kicked it off with the Kytec. We threw it in the 6.8. What fascinates me about a Kytec is how good all of them look. Because most baits, as you change sizes, the action gets lost. A bait might look great in a 3-inch, or a 5-inch, but it doesn't look good when you get to an 8-inch, or vice versa. Companies are always trying to add sizes, and it does not translate well. Kytec pulled it off. The 2.8, the 3.8, the 6.8 all look great. It's got a great tail kick. Obviously the price is right. It's rigged in this video on an owner beast hook. Every bait that you see with that jig hook in it, those are owner beast hooks. And I'll link all the baits, the hooks, our gear recommendations, everything in the video description for you. So if you want to see any of these baits, there's a link direct to them down below, so you don't even have to go try and find them. So it's rigged on a beast hook, great kick, great swim, very consistent, and great price. That's hard to beat. How about the Scottsboro? The Scottsboro is a real standout for me. I caught a pile of fish on that bait last fall. I did really well with it, again on that beast hook, creeping bottom, bouncing through rock. But this was the first time that I actually got to see it subsurface. As we were putting this video together, I got to see it the first time too, mid column. It's got a great tail kick, but it has amazing vibration as well. It's got that shimmy, that rock, it's got that magic. A lot of swim baits just have that tail kick. We tried to pick baits for this video that had more than that. Even back to the wedge tails, they've got head hunt. The Huddleston is more of a tail kick, it's the original. But the other two, they've got good tail kick, they also have that little bit of hunt, that little bit of secondary movement that's key. Well, back to this Scottsboro, it's got a ton of that rock and roll and movement, plus a good tail kick. That's hard to beat. How about that Magdraft, the Megabass Magdraft? That one surprised me. It looked really, really good. That was the 8-inch bait. I thought it was going to swim a little bit more nose down, and it really didn't. It swam flat, it swam true, great rock and roll, great tail kick. That bait really was a standout. They did a dynamite job with that one, and it comes pre-rigged. Now they have a second version of it called a Freestyle. I'll link that as well. If you prefer a beast hook or your own rigging, they have a version that you can just add a hook to. But the one we were throwing had a harness through it to a treble hook. That brings us to the last two. The last two are the osprey and the little creeper. Now, I have to confess on those two baits, those baits are actually designed to be fished slower and deeper. So they did not shine as well in this video as they deserve to. So know that going in. I should also add that the water that you just saw all these baits swim in, that water was 48 degrees. The warmer the water gets, the more exaggerated the kick will be on all of these baits. You're seeing all of them at almost worst case scenario where they're the most subtle. So all these baits, when you've got them in real world places for yourself, will look even better. So the osprey, if you noticed, it swam a little bit nose up. What that is about is because it's a very heavy bait. It's designed to be fished deep. If you've got fish that are dropped down in deep water, that's the bait for you because it'll go down and stay down and you can still fish it with some speed right along the bottom. Had a great kick, had great body roll in its natural environment. That bait is a killer. Then last but not least, the little creeper. The little creeper had a ton of movement, unlike any of the other swim baits in this video. But most important, that bait is ideally fished ultra slow on bottom, just creeping, just crawling it across the bottom. But I wanted to give a fair comparison between them, so we kept it up in the water column. All of the baits in today's video were winners. They all did a dynamite job. They look great and are worth your time and effort. If one of them is a standout for you, like I said, down in the video description, there's links to all of them, including the gear we use to rig them, our rods, line, all that stuff. Underwater footage does an amazing job of showing us how these baits truly operate. It's one thing to see a picture online. It's another thing to see a guy holding a fish that was caught on one. But when you can actually see the differences in how they move, how deep they're getting at the same speed, we were throwing them all at the same speed, you see those subtle differences, that makes all the difference so that you can select the right bait for you. Select a trout profile, select a shad profile, something with a lot of kick because you've got murky water, a lot of roll, a lot of kick, something a little more subtle so you can get down and creep it along the bottom for your lethargic fish. Whatever your circumstance, there is a swim bait that will get down there and help you catch big bass this spring. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications so you know when new videos are coming, and we'll talk to you soon.